Today I'm going to show you how to make strong, flexible masks that will not shrink and will last you forever, as long as you don't put a lot of pressure into ripping them. If you want to rip something, you're going to rip it. It's not metal, but it is the strongest and best rubber I can think of to use for a face mask. So what is it? ProFlex 50 from Mold Life. I will put the link in the video description box. There's one in England and there's one in the US. I think the company started in the US. This rubber is a polyurethane rubber. Comes in two parts. You mix equal amounts together in a mixing tray. Add the pigment, polyurethane pigment. This is white, but I've used it so it's covered in black. And you need a small glass of water. I'll tell you why. After you've slushed it around and it's begun to set, stop moving, you're going to need to push it around in some areas to even the level of rubber out. And the best way to do that is dip your fingers in some water, because it won't stick and it's going to evaporate afterwards anyway. Do it with a hairdryer if you want, and it won't stick. So you can, especially the nose area, you can take it out, spread it around some other areas. And this mold is Super Seal 25 silicone rubber with an Easy Flow 120 shell. I think I've made enough videos about how to make molds. And you need gloves, of course, and something to mix it with. These are pot labels you get from a plant shop. They're great, and they're cheap, and they don't stick to anything, so you can use them for over and over. So I'll show you how it's done. I have the scale set on ounces. I usually go for 2.0, but 2.2, it's not that much difference. Turn off your scales. That's both part A and part B in there. Equal amounts, 2.2 times 2 is 44. Now you add pigment. Haven't used this for a little while, so there you go. Give it a good amount of pigment. even though it's runny, it still has kind of a thick consistency. And you really mix in the pigment and give it a really good mix, scraping the sides and the bottom, so everything is mixed and you don't waste any, because this rubber is kind of expensive, but if you want the best results you have to pay for it. This can take a while, so I might have to turn the camera off. Slush it around, covering the whole of the inside of the mold. I'll turn the camera back on when it's set, as this does take a little while. See how I'm using the water to keep the nose free? Starting to set now. And let it stand for a bit. Actually, I think I'll hold it. Then add the second layer of rubber.
So this mask only needs two layers, and I've put in the second one. I've cleared out the nose area, so it's going to fit. And I'm going to let that set for a while, and later on I'll take it out of the mold and show you the cast. And this is the final product, the cast. So that's how you make flexible masks that keep their shape and do not shrink like latex. In the next video I'll show you how to wash them, because the mold will have mold release spray inside it, and it's really difficult to remove all of that, so you have to wash the casts after you pull them out of the mold. So there you have it. And latex really doesn't hold its shape, especially for face masks. Head masks, forehead masks, it's better, but face masks, no. Polyurethane is the material for face masks. Keep an eye out for the next video.